morning from Amplia Therapeutics is Dr. John Lambert. John, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. Good to be with you again.
Good to have you back, John. Your December quarterly out last week here, a strong period for you, essentially laying the foundations for a pivotal 2022. Before we look ahead, just give us a recap here on the December quarter.
So yeah, in the December quarter last year, we really put a lot of the pieces in place for the beginning of 2022. We raised $12.4 million in cash, taking us to an end of quarter cash balance of $16.2 million, which really does position us well to execute on our plans. We completed the manufacturing work for the clinical trial supply material. And in the process, we both, improved the manufacturing process and, increase the scale of that process. So, we really are putting some of the very key pieces in place to allow us to move this program forward and start some of these very useful regulatory interactions during 2022.
Well, this lead program here, AMP945, give us a bit more of an update and what the plans are.
So AMP945 is Amplia's leading drug development candidate. It's an inhibitor of a target called focal adhesion kinase, or FAK. And this year we intend to put AMP945 into two phase two clinical trials. One of them, which would be the first cab off the rank, is in pancreatic cancer, and the second is in pulmonary fibrosis. And those two clinical trials are scheduled to initiate around about 6 months apart from each other.
What's the delivery method for the molecule?
It's a small molecule, so it's delivered orally via the mouth in a capsule. We ran a phase one clinical trial that completed successfully early in 2021. And in that trial, we showed that when given by mouth, AMP945 is well absorbed and distributed throughout the body. And in fact, later in the year, we also showed that AMP945, when given orally, actually inhibits in humans the target that it's supposed to inhibit. So moving into phase two clinical trials, that's something that gives us a lot of comfort. We actually know that in humans, AMP945 hits the target it's intended to hit. And therefore, we hope to extrapolate from there into clinical efficacy and an impact on the diseases that we seek to treat.
And in the December quarter, you've appointed a clinical advisor to help oversee these trials.
That's true. We were really fortunate to be able to secure the services of a gentleman called Jose Iglesias. Jose is based in Canada, but he was one of the leading investigators on the clinical trials that showed that the current medicines that are used to treat pancreatic cancer were effective. So Jose knows pancreatic cancer and the treatment of it inside out. And so he's joined our team, and he's advising us as we move forward, both in the planning stages and in the execution stages of this clinical trial.
So gearing up here for two phase two clinical trials, you reckon potentially a watershed year ahead for Amplia?
We do. Phase two clinical trials in small molecule drug development, if they're successful, very significant value inflections. This is the time when we show whether or not these drugs actually work or not. And so 2022 is going to be a very important year as we start to see the data from these clinical trials emerging towards the end of the year. We will start to get a sniff of whether or not AMP945 is actually doing what it says on the tin.
Good to see you, John. Thanks very much.
You too. Thanks again, Andrew.